In this video, I am going to show you not one, not two, but three ways of making your own homemade clay. So friends, today we will see how you can make cold porcelain air dry clay with ingredients that mostly available at a home. All you need is cornstarch, white glue, baby oil, vinegar and some lotion, and follow this step-by-step process to make your own homemade cold porcelain clay. With this, I will also show you how to check whether your clay is well cooked, overcooked or undercooked, with some important tips regarding storage, coloring and curing your clay. But before we start, do subscribe this channel so that you get notification for all new upcoming videos. Let's start now. So our first method is cook air dry clay using a gas stove. Things you need for this is a non-stick pan, a wooden or silicone spatula for mixing, cling wrap, and a resealable plastic bag or any airtight container. And the measurements that we will use are 1 cup of cornstarch, 1 cup of PVA glue or white glue, 2 tablespoons of vinegar, or you can also use lemon juice here, and 2 tablespoons of baby oil or olive oil. Now our first step is mixing all the ingredients. In a non-stick pan, I am taking cornstarch and white glue in equal ratio. I have reduced the quantity in half as I wanted to make it for a small project only. If you want to make the clay for bigger projects, then you can increase the measurements in the same ratio. Now start mixing it and remove all the lumps here. Now I am adding vinegar in this mixture. It acts as a preservative for the clay and prevents the clay from getting molds or fungi. And oil helps in keeping the clay soft for a long time. Now we will mix it again and make a smooth batter. Make sure that there is no lumps here. And this mixture should have a smooth flowing consistency like this. Now our next step is cooking this mixture. Keep the gas on low flame and start cooking this mixture. You have to continuously stir the mixture while cooking to avoid any lumps here. Cook it evenly from all the sides also and try to flatten out all the lumps with the help of this spatula. Now you can see it starts thickening. Cook till the mixture stops sticking to pan and leaving the sides. At this stage, we will turn off the flame. Next step is kneading the clay. When you turn off the flame, quickly apply some lotion on the surface and start kneading the dough as soon as you take it out of the pan, even if it's hot. So be careful while kneading the dough. Initially, I am using this masher for kneading as the dough is really hot. Now it's cooled down a little, so I am going to knead it with my hands. Knead it till there is no lumps and it becomes soft and smooth. And the last and final step is storing the clay. Now our clay is ready. We will apply some lotion on the dough. Take a piece of the cling wrap and wrap the dough in this. Now I am using this resealable plastic bag and keeping the dough in this. You can also use any airtight container here. Now let the clay set for minimum 6 hours at least before use. Method 1 is done here. In our second method, we will see how to make cooked air dry clay using a microwave oven. In this method, in place of a non-stick pan, we will use a microwave safe ball and rest all other things are same, and we will use the same measurements in this method also. First, we will mix all the ingredients in the bowl. For tutorial purpose, I am making this in a small quantity. That's why I have taken all the ingredients in less quantities. Mix it till there are no lumps here. Now keep it in microwave and first cook it for 10 to 15 seconds only. After 10 seconds, I am taking it out and mixing it properly so that there is no lumps here. And now again, I am going to microwave it for 10 more seconds. As its quantity is very less, so it is cooked now and we will knead the dough in the same way as we have done in our previous method. If you are making it in bigger quantity, so you can repeat this process 4 to 5 times, microwave it for 15 seconds at a time and taking it out to stir in between. When kneading is done, wrap it in a cling wrap and keep it in an airtight container or bag. Now in our third method, we will make air dry clay without cooking it. Here the measurements are little different. You can note this down. The ratio of cornstarch and glue is 2:1 here. In a mixing bowl, I am taking one part of cornstarch and half part of glue. Adding oil and vinegar also. Now we will mix it. As you can see, my mixture looks too liquidy, so I am going to add some more cornstarch in this and again mix it. This recipe is quite flexible, so you can vary its measurements according to its consistency. Now apply some lotion on the surface and start kneading till it gets smooth texture. Now wrap it and store it in a resealable plastic bag or container. Our all three methods are done. So now we will check the consistency of the clay and test if it is well cooked or not. We will perform three checks here. Test number 1, it should form a teardrop shape. Take a small amount of the clay and knead it first. Now pull it apart. It should form a teardrop shape like this. Test number 2, it should have a smooth surface. Roll a piece of clay in round shape. It should have a smooth surface like a ball. Test number 3, no cracks or creases. Make a round ball of the clay and press it like this with your hand or any object. The flattened piece should not have any cracked edges or creases on it. So by doing all these three tests, you can check the consistency of your clay. If you overcook the clay, it will become dry and rubbery like this. This was my first trial of the cooked cold porcelain clay which got overcooked and it's become dry and rubbery and breaking like this. If your clay is overcooked, then you can try adding a little more oil and knead it again, or you can make another batch of undercooked clay and mix it with an overcooked batch. And if your clay is undercooked, then it will be sticky like this. It will stick to your hands and to the surface also. You can try to fix this undercooked clay by mixing some more cornstarch in this, or you can cook it again for few more seconds. Before we proceed further, here are some important tips. Number 1. Before using, let the clay set for minimum 6 hours. Number 2. Knead every piece of the clay before shaping it. Number 3. You can store the leftover clay in the refrigerator for 1 to 2 weeks for the next use. Number 4. Always wrap the clay and store it in an airtight container. Now let's see how to color the cold porcelain clay. It can be done in two ways. Method 1. By mixing colors in the dough. For making colored cold porcelain, I am using acrylic colors here. These works well with most of the art forms. Take some acrylic colors and knead it with dough till it gets mixed well in the dough. And then you can shape the clay in the design you want. Like I have made these mini clay flowers with this colored cold porcelain. And this flower I have made using this plain clay without any colors so that I can show you the difference in both. Our second method is painting on your artwork. In this method, first you can sculpt the clay and when it's dry, you can apply colors on your artwork. Like I have colored this rose flower with red color. Now let's compare the cooked and not cooked cold porcelain clay. First we will compare its shrinkage. After drying, cold porcelain clay shrinks around 10 to 15% at least. First we will check for not cooked clay. So I am taking some clay and making this heart shape using a cookie cutter. And this heart shape I have made it 2 days ago using the same cookie cutter. So you can see the difference. There is very less shrinkage in this. Now let's check it for the cooked cold porcelain clay. This heart shape I have just made it using this cookie cutter and this one I have made it 2 days before. So you can see that there is more shrinkage in this cooked cold porcelain clay. So if we compare these both cooked and not cooked clay together, so you can see the difference in percentage of shrinkage of both. Now let's compare their color saturation. This is the not cooked clay and this is cooked clay after drying. And you can see that not cooked clay is more opaque in finish and colors looks more saturated in this. On the other hand, the cooked cold porcelain clay looks translucent and less saturated in colors. So, how to decide which clay to use? In my opinion, you can use the cooked cold porcelain for the intricate designs and fine detailings. You can even make the paper thin flower petals with this cooked cold porcelain clay. Not cooked cold porcelain is suitable for simple projects where you don't want to achieve much detailing. And it's not very durable, it might get cracks also. So friends, in this video I have tried to cover most of the points related to cold porcelain clay. And I hope it cleared all your doubts related to making the clay and using it. Try making this homemade cold porcelain clay at home. And if you have any questions, then let us know in the comments below. And if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching. See you next time.